As you know, there's a big coronavirus pandemic. And one of the big things that kind of limits how we can address the virus is who has the virus. When someone has coronavirus, some of the virus is shed in their feces. So what we're trying to do is kind of use wastewater to quantify how many people in a community have coronavirus. So what we're doing up here at the manhole is we're sampling probably between 20 and 50 houses just up the hill here.
As the outbreak was kind of ramping up in the Greek system, we thought this would be a really good spot just to see if we could detect COVID or see a trend as COVID changes in this area.
And so we're collecting kind of downstream from those houses, the wastewater, and hoping that we can kind of monitor one of the biggest outbreaks in at least the city of Seattle. This pump station collects wastewater from the University Village as well as just north of here. And so right now we have an auto sampler set up, so we're able to collect samples 7 days a week, 24 hours a day. And then we take that back to the lab and look for coronavirus. I think wastewater is exciting. It's a little bit gross, but it's really useful. Most of the solids you see are just toilet paper. Really what we want is the feces to be able to get the coronavirus, but they dissolve pretty quickly.
This is the raw wastewater sample, and I just mix it up to, you can see there's like a little bit of suspended or like settled solids there.
Let's see, so this was run on the 3rd. So basically every red box means the sample is negative, and the green boxes mean the sample tested positive for coronavirus.
Sewer sampling can allow us to check in individual neighborhoods where's the fire burning. So it is kind of a smoke detector to show where is an upgoing trend and where are things actually okay. That is a lot cheaper than testing all these individuals in these different areas and allows us to monitor with just one sample all these different communities to see where is an upward trend, where is a downward trend.